What is up everyone, my name is FM Sorcerer, and today I'll be showing you all a new quest for a shadow spell that we will be getting, as well as the new Arcanum Shadow Classroom and a new mount and bundle. So all of this information was found in the Wizard101 files, and if you want to know what the name of the source is that found it, I will have that in the description so you can see that all of this is real. But let's get started.
Well, if it isn't my favorite partner in Shadow. I know, I should have reached out, but I had to go around the spiral chasing shadows. Literally. From what I heard, you've been chasing shadows of your own. The biggest one of all, in fact. Grandfather Spider. Honestly, I'm a little jealous. I guess it's not all fun and games, though. This business about Ione not trusting you kind of burns, doesn't it? I know, I got the same treatment. For the other scholars, this shadow stuff is still scary. They don't yet grasp that it's a key part of the spiral. Until then, it'll be tough. I didn't invite you here for a self-pity party, though. I invited you because I found a cool new spell, the Shadow Trickster. Yep, you just need a Trickster Essence. And since I'm such a good friend, I found one for you. Take Portal, get Essence, come back, and bingo!
The Child of Light and Shadow here in Darkmoor? To what do I owe the honor? You came all this way to see me? Why, I'm flattered. But flattery will get you nowhere, of course. I prefer the reward Grandfather Spider's offering for your capture. Yes, let us duel. No, you can't take my essence that would bind me to your will, and then no, no!
Hey there, Hotshot. You've got that smug I just wiped the floor with a shadow trickster look, so I'm guessing your little jaunt was a success. All right then, you got your essence, so here's the trick with the trickster. Cast this little spell and you can take on his form. And his skills. I need to get back to work. I hear they've got an infestation of shadowfish in the floating lands, so I'll be on the beach. Ugh. See ya!
Alright, so that was the quest for our next new Shadow Spell, which we'll probably be getting in the summer or fall update once again. But as you could hear, Velma had us visit her in the new Arcanum Shadow Classroom to tell us about a portal that leads to Darkmoor. What's really interesting though is that she brought up that not only does Ione have a lack of trust for us, but she also does not trust Velma, and that the scholars do not yet grasp that shadow magic is a key part to the spiral. And that is a pretty interesting comment, because Grandmother Raven is hating so much on old Cobb and her shadow magic that she might not realize that shadow magic is really essential to the spiral. Now for the quest, Velma has us go through the portal to Darkmoor to get the Trickster Essence, and you can see right here, this is where we'll fight the boss. And it actually looks pretty nice. It's probably one of the better looking dungeons that we've had in the game in a while. Right here is what the boss looks like. He definitely looks pretty cool and evil. Another interesting thing though is how the Shadow Trickster mentioned that Grandfather Spider is offering a reward for our capture, which could mean that Old Cobb needs us for his plan. It could also be a nod to the Chrysalis Orb prophecy and that we were the child all this time and that right now we're not on the right side. Now this is the spell that we get from the Shadow Trickster, and once we go back to Velma, she lets us know that once you cast it, you take on his form and skills. Here's what it looks like when you use it in battle. So maybe this could be similar to polymorphing and it will allow us to use unique shadow cards when we use it, but we'll have to see. Here's what the Arcanum Shadow Classroom looks like. It looks really nice, it has a nice wide open space and some Darkmoor lore, which could actually be where Velma is from. So all of this is really awesome and we will have to more than likely wait and see it in the summer update. So now for the rest of the video, I'll show you all a new mount and bundle. This is the Shark Ski Runner mount, which will have 50% speed, and that's definitely going to add value to it and entice some people to want to buy it even more. Here's how it looks. It sort of reminds me of a cross between a shark, a plane, and a boat, of course. Personally, I really like how this mount looks, and I usually don't buy mounts in the crown shop, but I actually might get this one when it comes out. So we're supposed to be getting a new bundle that's celestial themed, and it's also going to have a gauntlet. And you can see right here, this is sort of what the gauntlet looks like. It has a lot of water surrounding this ship with a beach that you can see in the far distance. And here's another view where you can see the beach as well. I actually really like the way this looks. I like the clouds and the water and just how you can see those islands all in the distance. It looks really chill. And I don't usually get bundles once again, but I actually might get this bundle. You can see in these pictures what the inside of the ship looks like. It's pretty dim lit and it's got a lot of crates inside of it and also some ship equipment, so it will probably be a nice little place where you can store some of your housing items. And you can also see in this picture that there's a little staircase that you would come down in where you would enter the room. So these are the stats for the gear, and you can see that each piece gives these unique item cards that are non-PvP. This set is level 130 and up, and the stats for the hat are 620 health, 7% power pip chance, 8% accuracy, 4% pierce, 20% damage, 140 crit, 3% shadow pip chance. And they give two cards for a new spell called Dragon Lance, which has plus 35% damage and plus 10% pierce. This could be a really useful card if King's Isle ever decided to make it trainable or allowed in PvP. That would definitely be really good. But the robe has 1,240 health, 7% power creep chance, 20% resist, 10% incoming health, 6% stun resist, 124 crit block, and 3% shadow pip chance. The stats for this robe actually aren't that bad, and it could be a pretty good jade substitute. It also gives a new card called Double Steel Ward. Now this could be an interesting new mechanic, because Wiz players have wanted this for a while. The only thing is it's non-PvP at the moment, but maybe it could be made a trainable utility spell in the next update or something along those lines. The boots have 825 health, 6% power pip chance, 20% damage, 15% resist, 10% outgoing health, 118 crit, and 2% shadow pip chance. And once again, it gives one of the same mechanic spells. This time, it's double cleanse charm, which lots of players have asked for due to juju and dispel spamming. I think KI is one step closer to finally getting things right, and if they made this trainable one day, so many players would be happy. Alright, so the final thing I wanted to show you all was this new pet called the Peppy Porpoise, which is a life pet that comes with the Celestial Explorer's Gauntlet. So it's a pretty nice pet, it's got cool green eyes, and it definitely looks like a pretty adorable pet. But yeah, I hope you all enjoyed this video. I'm definitely looking forward to some of the new stuff here. Let's try to aim for 35 likes for some new theories that I will be making in this upcoming week, and I hope you all are having a great day. I will see you all in the next vid.
My mother told me that the world has got its plans. I wanna hold them till they burn right through.